챕터 22, The Civil War, Fort Sumter, Civil War, A War Within One Country, Rather Than Between Two Different Nations. Soon after his inauguration, President Lincoln learned that supplies for federal troops at Fort Sumter, which was located in the harbor of Charleston, South Carolina, were running out. Sending more supplies could provoke war. After alerting the CSA, Lincoln sent unarmed supply ships. In response, on April 12, 1861, the Confederacy attacked Fort Sumter. The fort surrendered 2 days later. The Civil War had begun. For the state, Lincoln called on state militias to supply troops for what he estimated would be 3 months of fighting. In response, North Carolina, Tennessee, Virginia, and Arkansas ceded. They refused to bear arms against Little Palou, Southerners, and saw Lincoln's action as unjust. Border states where slavery was legal but not such a big part of the economy, Delaware, Kentucky, Maryland, and Missouri stayed in the Union. In 1863, the part of Virginia loyal to the Union, West Virginia, became the USA's 35th state, North versus South. The North, the Yankees, were the Union, who wore blue uniforms, had a bigger population, more transport option, especially railroad, more factories and production capacity, and more money. The South, the liberal, were the Confederate, who wore gray uniform, had influence on the world cotton market. The South needed to fight a defensive war. They hoped to foreign invasion and planned to hold out until the North got weary, tired of a war. The North needed to fight a more active war and subdue the rebels. Defeat, suppress, overcome. Both armies consist mostly of inexperienced volunteers who signed up for only 90 days of fighting. Together, North and South faced the scary reality of a war and put brother against brother. North versus South. Blue. Gray 유니폼, 블루 유니폼. States, Union, Confederacy, CSA, claimed by CSA. The first battle of the Bull Run. In July of 1861, the Union Army tried to take Richmond, Virginia, which had become the CSA capital. The Confederate troops met the Union Army at Manassas, Virginia, which was a key railroad junction near Bull Run Creek. Neither side was ready. On July 21, the Union force crossed the creek and pushed back all of the rebels, except for the unit led by General Thomas Jackson, who received the nickname Stonewall for refusing to move. Under Stonewall Jackson, the Confederate Army pushed the Union troops back to Washington, D.C. The first battle of the Bull Run showed both sides that this war was going to be more dangerous and difficult than expected. Rebel yell. The Confederate Army was known for screaming loudly when they were under attack, so their battle cry was known as the Lebel Well, George McLean and Ulysses S. Grant. Lincoln brought in General George McLean to lead the Union Army of the Potomac. McLean trained his troops for almost a year, but convinced that the Confederate troops were too powerful, hesitated to attack. Meanwhile, Union forces in the West, led by Ulysses S. Grant, were taking port, gaining ground, and taking over trade and supply routes. Admiral David Farragut led Navy troops to take New Orleans, wrapping his wooden ships in heavy chains to protect them like ironclad. New military technology. One of the most significant new inventions of the Civil War was ironclad warship. A ship that was armed with iron. Other major innovations were the repeating rifle, which could fire more than one bullet before it had to be reloaded, and the mini-ball bullet soldiers could shoot farther and more accurately. War become a whole lot deadlier. The Big Battles. The Battle of Shiloh. The Confederate Western troops retreated to Collins, Mississippi. Grant's army followed closely behind, stopping near Shiloh, Church, and Tennessee to wait for the reinforcement of April 6, 1862. Albert Sidney Johnston, leader of the Confederacy's Western troops, and his soldier ambushed Grant's camp. Over 2 days, the Union forces were able to push the Confederate back into Mississippi, but both sides lost a huge number of soldiers in the Battle of Shiloh. The Peninsula Campaign. Lincoln was frustrated with McLean's hesitation. McLean finally announced a plan to move the entire army by boat to Virginia's Royal Peninsula, a huge and slow operation. He wanted to enter the James River Peninsula to attack Richmond from the south. By the time he got there, the Confederates were ready to attack. Chesapeake Bay, Union, Confederate, Richmond, Yorktown, Williamsburg, York River, West Point. 맥클레인's army suffered heavy losses and was forced to retreat by the Confederate Army of Northern Virginia, led by Robert E. Lee. The Second Battle of Bull Run. In August 1862, in the Second Battle of Bull Run, the rebels gained another victory. Antietam. Lee decided to attack the North. A victory there would take the war to Northern soil, encouraging Britain to join the war. It was also designed to help Virginia farmers harvest their crop by moving the battle loss. In September 1862, the Confederate Army crossed the Potomac into Frederick, Maryland. This is Washington, D.C., Maryland, Virginia, Bullen, Antietam, Sharpsburg, Frederick. Lee planned to divide his army into three units, which made him vulnerable to attack. A Union soldier found a copy of Lee's marching order in an abandoned rebel camp. When McLean learned of the plan. He was slow to act, and he could have used this secret information to get an advantage. 2 days later, on September 17, the two armies met near Sasburg, Maryland, at the Battle of Antietam, which became the single deadliest one-day battle in all of the U.S. history. After Lee retreated, McClellan didn't follow with an attack. Lincoln fired McClellan. Combined casualty were 23,000 killed, wounded, or missing. The emancipation, freeing, liberation, emancipation setting free, proclamation. According to Lincoln, the Civil War wasn't being fought to end slavery. It was to preserve the Union. At first, he didn't want to upset the border states. The Union victory of Antietam gave him more confidence. On January 1, 1863, Lincoln issued the Emancipation Proclamation. He did not have the constitutional power to end slavery, but he had the authority to seize enemy property, including slaves. So this military order could free all slaves in any area that was in rebellion. The Emancipation Proclamation transformed the Civil War into a moral crusade campaign, moral crusade against slavery, and it encouraged some slaves to escape. However, the Union Army could not actively ensure that slaves were freed. Nonetheless, it also prevented foreign intervention because no European power would fight to restore or preserve slavery. Although many whites doubted black soldiers' courage and ability to fight, they most famously, the 54th Massachusetts Volunteers Regiment Regiment proved their bravery after Congress allowed them to fight. There were 175 United States Colored Troops, U.S. City Regiment, by the end of the Civil War, which constituted 10% of the entire Union Army. The home front,